Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die. Let the drama kick, let the drama kick die.
To follow it everywhere.
Yeah.
Oh.
Hi guys, Luke here again. I'm out in the field today and the weather's not so great, so I thought I'd take a chance to show you my charging station, which I made a while ago, but just haven't gotten around to making a YouTube video yet. So here it is. It's completely different to my other one. I've changed the chargers, but I've kept the same power supply. This is one of my Crudd Parts creations. It's an acrylic surround, which I milled on my CNC machine, which I've taken up as a hobby now. It features two auxiliary ports again, and this time I've got a 15-amp punching plug on the back so I can tug down. What else? The chargers are more powerful and capable of pressing up these 6L packs at a maximum of 40 amps, whereas my previous setup was limited to 30. So I've just discharged these two 65C 5000 and I'm going to hook it up to the laptop and we'll charge it and see how quick I can press these up at 40 amps. Hopefully they won't burst into flames, so stay tuned. Just one other thing I forgot to mention, and that's what I'm actually using to power all this at the field. It's my generator just around the front of the car here. It's 4,400 watts. I don't know if that's continuous or peak. It's just a cheap eBay generator. I paid $500 for it and don't buy one. It's terrible. I pulled the full start cable out and I've converted it to LiPo start, so anyway, that's what's going to be supplying us the power to press up these packs today. Yeah. These chargers are the Revolectrix CellPro PL8 chargers, which most of you out there now are probably familiar with. They also do a line of batteries. I have to say that these batteries are amazing for the price. I still am a huge ThunderPower fan, but these batteries cost half the price. They come in a great stick pack like this for the safety of Goblin. You just slot it straight in there. There's no, you know, connecting up other leads, and it's very neat setup. And I'll probably put over 120 flights on just one of these packs alone in my Goblin with the stump on motor. It's taken a bit of beating and it still holds up really well. So if you're in the market for batteries, definitely recommend checking out the Revolectrix site for this brand. Okay, so it's all hooked up to the computer here, and we're going to graph the progress as it charges, and I'm hoping for under 8 minutes, at least around the 7 minute mark, for pressing these up.
It's done.
Okay guys, just finished charging then, and the results are one charged in 8 minutes and 50 seconds and the other one charged in 8 minutes and 17 seconds, so that's a significant improvement over my previous setup. well, significant means sort of 1 minute faster, really, but from memory, I think my quickest charge on the high chargers was about 9 minutes, 20 seconds. I think you're around there, correct me if I'm wrong, but it charged these pretty quickly. The packs reached 100% in 5 minutes, which is incredible because we're discharging these packs in about 4 minutes and 30 seconds to the 5 minute mark. So they're effectively acting as a capacitor, which is very interesting. So it spent the remainder of that time just balancing the packs. That's probably all you guys want to know, hopefully. So if you guys got your own setup or you want to ask me a few more questions about mine, please feel free to post a comment or subscribe to my channel and I'll catch up with you later. So I'm going to go now. Get a bit more flying done before I go home. Catch you later.